Hi, this is Joe Bolen. Today we're going to get our ducks lined up in order. We're going to be talking about tab stops. Up to this point in all the videos that I've created, I've shown you the program with the correct tab order. And I did that because I wanted you to not worry about that as an issue. But what happens is if we do not put our controls on the form in the order we end up wanting our tab order, the tab order will not be correct for our program. So I want to show you how to correct your tab order so you don't have to worry about the order in which you put your different controls on your form. So let's get into our program and you'll see what I'm talking about. I have on the screen my very simple calculator, and right now I'd like to highlight the division button. And the division button has for its one of its properties the tab index. In this case it's 0, which means it's going to be the first control to receive focus as we tab through the different controls. And because the tab stop property is true, it can receive focus. And we'll see other controls with different tab index values, but the tab stop property will be true. Now let's take a look at a label. I'm going to go to the result label. And you'll see that that particular one has a tab index, but it does not have a tab stop property. A label cannot receive focus. So while we can't set the tab index, what happens is as you tab through the different controls, instead of going to the result label for focus of the particular control, it'll jump to the next control. In this case, it's going to jump to another label, which also cannot receive focus. So then it will jump properly to the next button, in this case, going down. So we go from top down, left to right in our tab order process. So let's see our fouled up tab order first. I'm going to start to compile the program. And here's our program, and you see that the first thing that had control was the division button with a tab index of 0. Now I'm going to use my tab key and go through the different controls as it currently has its settings. You'll go to the minus 1, then jump up to the second number text box, then to the multiplication button, then to the plus button, then to the clear button, and then finally up to the first number text box, then back down to the division button. Well, that's definitely not what we want to have happen for the user's experience. So let's reset the tab orders. And it's a very easy thing to do in the design view of the form. What we do is we come up to the view on our menu bar, drop down on it, and pick tab order. And at that point, all the controls have a number associated with them showing their current tab order. What we do to get it corrected is we just come up and click on each one as we want the order. So we go to the first number label, which will have a tab index, but it will not have a tab stop value. And then we'll go to the first number text box, come down, and we just keep clicking, changing the order. Till we have everything set the way we want them. And then it resets back to a solid color and we have everything set. At that point I just hit the escape key. All the orders have changed. I recompile the program. And now let's take a look at the program after the tab order has been set. Right now the control has gone from the first number jumping on over to the text box where it can receive control. Then I'm going to hit the tab key now and watch it jump to the second number text box. Then it'll go to the plus, minus, multiplication, division, and then clear back to the first number text box. And that is exactly what we want to do. We have our ducks lined up in order. So, as you work with your program, if you happen to put the controls on your form and the order after doing so is not what you want, all you need to do is go into the view on your menu bar, drop down to tab order, and then click on the sequence that you want the user to have for a tab order. This makes it a very good experience for the user as they enter in data. Ideally, we want a heads-down type of data entry system where the user has to do very little with the mouse, can do most of everything with the keyboard, including the tab key. So get your hands dirty in the code, get your tab order set, or as I would like to say, get your ducks lined up in the right order, and get your hands dirty in that code. Till next time, take care.